Ready?
Yeah.
Cole?
Okay, I'm recording.
Now concentrate, Jodie. Tell me if you feel anything in particular about any of these objects.
Can you see anything, Aiden? Her music box.
Laura.
Yeah. Nathan? Okay, I'll tell him. Nathan, someone named Ryan Clayton is here to see you. He says you know what it's about.
Yes. I'll be back in a moment.
Do you know this guy who's come to see Nathan?
No idea.
I'm so hungry. When do we get a break?
Yeah, I'm hungry too. We need to get Nathan out of here for once. Somewhere fancy. I'm sick of cafeteria food.
I hope we don't finish too late. I have tons of homework to do. You know, Nathan's always complaining when I get bad grades. He's always keeping me here when I should be studying.
That's a discussion you'll have to have with him, Princess.
Do you think he'll be long?
Relax, Princess. He'll be back in a minute.
Hasn't Nathan been... I don't know, just... like, acting kind of strange lately?
He's trying to raise money for the lab at the moment. Maybe he's worried about it. You know how he is. Hey, where are you going? Aren't you gonna wait for Nathan?
What's going on, Nathan? You look upset.
Jodie, this is Ryan Clayton from the CIA. The agency wants you to join their military school program at Camp Perry. Ryan's going to take care of you from now on. You have to go with him, Jodie. Today.
What about the experiments? I thought we were working together.
I'm sorry, Jodie. It's out of my hands.
I am not a child. I can make my own decisions. No one can force me to go.
Hey, Jodie, I know. It's difficult, but you need to understand, this is a great opportunity for you.
No one can tell me what to do with my life.
Jesus, listen up, Miss Holmes. I don't give a shit about your pathetic adolescent pouting, all right? You can rant and rave all you want, but you'll shut your mouth and do as you're told.
Go fuck yourself.
That's it. Let's go. Come here.
Stop immediately.
Please. Do this for me.
I'll go get my things.
Only the essentials. We've got everything you need at Camp Perry.
Don't worry. I'm sure you'll be great.
gonna miss the hell out of you, princess.
I'll come and see you as soon as I can. I'll never let you down. You know that, don't you? Be there for you.
Time to go.
Yeah?
Jodie. Hey, it's Ryan.
Ryan!
I was just wondering if you got my email.
What email?
The one I sent 3 days ago.
You know, I've actually been having problems with my computer. What was the email about?
Dinner, tonight, fancy restaurant. Anyway, it's too late now, so... maybe another time?
Shit, I'm so sorry. Why don't you just come over here for dinner tonight? I mean, you wanted to see my apartment anyway, so...
Sure, but I...
How about around 8?
Okay. Yeah, I'll bring a kick-ass bottle of wine. See you later.
Now I get why you blasted my computer. You didn't want me to see Ryan. It's not your call, Aiden. I can do what I want. Fuck this. We're not gonna start this again. I'm not yours, Aiden. I can have a relationship with whoever I want. This is my life. Okay, do you fucking hear me? This is my life. You know what? I happen to think Ryan is great. He's charming, he's intelligent, he's funny. And I think I'm falling for him. Okay. It's 7:00. I have an hour to make dinner, tidy up, and make myself look. The trash can in the kitchen. I gotta find something I can make in 1 hour with what's ever left in the fridge. Asian beef, oh, I mean, that looks good. It's not too complicated. Curried chicken with oven-baked vegetables. It'll take some time in the oven, but it seems doable. Pizza delivery. I mean, it's not exactly gourmet, but it, no preparation, no mess. I mean, it could be an option. time to decide, girl. Yeah. Asian beef. I mean, it looks suitably exotic. As long as I don't manage to fuck it up. Thanks, Aiden. So far, so good. Use a walk. Ginger. It's supposed to be an aphrodisiac. I mean, it's not in the recipe, but it can't hurt. I mean, I need all the help I can get. All right, add the sake for flavor. Oh. I think I'm beginning to like cooking. Ryan, you are gonna love this. Oh, crap. Crap, he's early. I'm coming! Oh, good one, Aiden. Okay, you got me. Now, open the door. Aiden, come on, open up! Play too. You know, you're wasting your time, Aiden. You're not gonna stop me from seeing Ryan. Books. Okay, on the bookshelf. Okay, great. Dirty clothes in the basket in the bathroom. All right, there. Christ, Aiden. Look, you just don't get it. I've got to change. What should I wear? Oh, hello, Ryan. Oh, do you like it? Classic, elegant, a je ne sais quoi. I don't want to give them the wrong idea. Oh. Oh, hey, Ryan. Yeah, whatever. I just, like, threw these old things on, because... Yeah, I'm cool. I'm cool. Yeah, I'm just gonna be me. I mean, there's no point in me throwing myself at the guy. You might as well just give up, Aiden. Okay? This date is going on. Period. Come on, Aiden, don't be a pain in the ass. I didn't behave yourself. Okay, this is important to me, and I'm counting on you.
Chateau Margaux, 2001. The guy in the store said it was a pretty good year.
That sounds good to me, so. Why don't you sit? I'll get the thing that opens the wine.
Cool apartment.
Huh? Yeah, thanks. Aiden, for fuck's sakes.
You want me to open it?
No, no, I'll do it.
To your new apartment.
To my new apartment.
Oh, so when did you move in?
A couple weeks ago. Yeah, the agency found it for me and all furnished and everything, which is... It's actually the first place I've ever had, just by myself, so... It's weird getting used to the idea of it. And how about you? Where do you live?
Oh, I have a place just outside of town. Yeah, it's small, but, you know, it's got a little garden and it's pretty quiet.
And did you grow up here?
No, I was born in Oregon. Yeah, my parents and brother still live there. But I moved out when I was 16.
16? Oh. Did you get kicked out or something?
Well, things were pretty chaotic at home. My stepfather liked to beat me when he had too much to drink. And I just decided to get out before one of us went too far.
How did you end up joining the CIA?
I went through college, not really knowing what I wanted to do. Tried the army. Travel adventure. Long enough to realize that wasn't for me. And when a CIA agent recruiter approached me, I jumped at it.
I should probably, you know, I'm gonna go check on the dinner because this cooking thing, it's a whole new adventure for me.
You need help?
No, but why don't you go sit and more wine would be nice.
Okay. Asian beef, right?
Yeah.
No, I was sent to China for a year. I love Asian food. Oh,
well, do not get your hopes up, because this is probably the second time that I've cooked, and I would rather not talk about the first time.
This is good.
Good. I'm glad you like it.
So we've been working together now for what, 2 years? I know almost nothing about you.
I mean, there's nothing much to say. I grew up with my parents on the DPA campus, and then Nathan looked after me, and, well, I mean, you pretty much know the rest, so.
Yeah, your parents, do you still see them?
No, I don't. I think they were just terrified about how different I was. So Nathan and Cole, they brought me up more or less. They taught me how to cope with Aiden, how to accept myself as I am. I mean, it wasn't always easy, but you know, I'm making progress.
You know, did Nathan ever manage to explain to you why you have this link with Aiden?
No. I mean, not really. I mean, they learned a lot of stuff about the infra world. Really not much about Aiden. I mean, I don't think even he knows who or what he is.
So, like, is he here now, listening to us?
Yeah. Yeah, he never leaves me. What about you? Do you have any family here?
No, my parents are still in Oregon. Go to see them as little as possible.
And are you married or anything?
No. Yes, I mean I was. You know, my ex-wife and I have been separated for 2 years, and I couldn't work. I mean, in the end, it didn't. You know, we had our good times, but eventually we decided to go our separate ways. How about you? Anyone on your radar?
I've got Aiden, so.
I mean, anyone in our world.
You know, Aiden kind of has always made people run away. Or maybe it's me. Maybe I'm just too odd for anyone to be interested in.
You're special, Jodie. Aiden's got nothing to do with this.
Hey, Aiden. Thank you.
Nathan, I'm so tired. Can we go now?
Oh, jeez. Is that what time it is? I'm sorry. I was concentrating on my work. I know you've had a long day. Hey, this morning I bought your book. What do you say we get you tucked in and I read to you?
Yes, please.
I must have left it in the other room. Why don't you go in there and get it? I'll finish up here, and then we can go, okay?
Sure, I'm on it. So, where did he leave that book? Stop it, Aiden. It's not funny. Aiden? Are you doing that, Aiden?
You found it. Now we can get down to the serious business of bedtime stories. Jodie, you okay? You look pale.
She looks dead tired is how she looks. Come on, Nathan, let's get her off to bed. Yes. Yes, hold on. Nathan, it's for you.
Nathan Dawkins.
Nathan? Nathan, what's up?
They were coming back from my mother's. Truck. Wrong driver. Wrong side of the road.
dead?
Jody, let's get you off to bed. Nathan, stay right here. I'll be right back. Come on, Jody.
Jamal Sheikh Sharif, one of the most dangerous warlords in the country. He commands a heavily armed militia, using it to control several important districts in the city, which means none of our humanitarian aid is getting through. You have to find Jamal and eliminate him. Now, he relocates twice a day. Last time we pinpointed him was at the Zanaki Hotel, which is right here. Not much of a chance he's still there, but it's as good a place as any to start looking. You'll be on your own this mission. No direct engagement with the enemy, no backup. You identify and eliminate your target, then activate your GPS beacon so we can extract you. We need to get you out before sunrise, so don't waste any time. But the last American soldier that was captured here was pulled through the city behind a Jeep. They found his head, one of his legs, in a fishing boat.
I'll be back before they even realize what's happened. Don't worry. I'll be fine.
No direct engagement with the enemy. No backup.
Check that there are no soldiers around, Aiden.
Last time we pinpointed him was at the Zanaki Hotel, which is right here.
See if you find anything. Great. Now let's go.
أنني لست من مؤيديه.
يا كذاب، لقد رأيتك بنفسي. أنت ميؤوس منه. عارا سنكون سعداء للتخلص منه.
هل تمت؟
الجميع محتاج.
The Zanaki Hotel. They've gone. Cathedral. They're near a ruined cathedral. There's one not far from here. Should be easy to find. Mall. He was here.
سبارد في الصباح مساخن كان شخيف
لليانصيب أين قائدكم شمال الآن؟ نعم؟
إنه لا يستطيع
Cathedral. From where did I see it in my vision? They came here. Someone almost did the job for me.
baby! Well, like a Taltec!
Easy. Look wounded. I just want to help you. I'm gonna come towards you. Don't shoot me, okay? He's lost a lot of blood. He's gonna die if I don't help him.
ساحرة أنت ساحرة كيف يمكنك فعل ذلك؟
Sorry, I don't understand a word you're saying.
سالم سالم.
Your name is Salim.
سالم.
Jodie. I'm Jodie.
Jodie?
Yeah, Jodie.
Jodie.
Looks like we have some new friends.
احترسوا قد تكون مسلحة.
Gotta get closer. Get out of here before more show up.
تخيل هل هو سبتي؟
It's okay. It's okay. I'm all right. We make a damn good team, don't we, Salim? The sun is rising. It's gonna make it tough to not be seen now.
Over there.
That's where I need to go.
What
have I got to lose?
No choice. We're going straight through.
Stay close, okay?
Wait! Help me! Get rid of
him.
Take it slow, Aiden. We'll try to get by without being noticed.
Thank you.
sleep. طيب لموزبي أي أذى.
This is where we have to go our separate ways. I must go. Do you understand, Salim?
لا نتركك. يمكنني البقاء ولا جانبك. حاستي مساعدتك.
I'm sorry, but you can't come with me. You're really brave, Salim. Someday, this is all gonna be over. And you can just go back to being a kid.
لك حد انكست يا حياتي. لن انسى فعلك هذا ابدا.
Jamal was around here somewhere. I don't have much time. The tower. I need to get to the tower. That's it. Jamal's here. Okay, now find a place close to the house where I can take cover. You know what you have to do. Find Jamal, Aiden. Don't stop. You're close. That's Jamal. I won't be able to get close enough. You're gonna have to do it, Aiden. No, Aiden. Gotta keep a low profile. Good. Now find a weapon. To do it. Orders are orders. The guy's got blood on his hands. He deserves to die. Come on. I can do this. I can kill him. I can kill him.
هذا يجب علينا أن نطاردهم أينما كان ونجعل توحيد البلاد.
Open the door for me. I need to confirm that Jamal is dead. Hurry! Salim?
Abi! Abi! La! La tamut ya Abi! أنا بحاجة إليك لا تتركني لا تتركني.
He's your father.
لماذا فعلت ذلك؟ فكرت أنا كساتيكا تي. انا اكرهك. اتركيني. ابتعدي عني.
10 years in the CIA, never seen anything like it. Boss sends his own private helicopter to get an agent back.
All the top brass are crazy about you, Jodie. You and Aiden, of course. Jodie, you okay? Listen, I know this one was tough, but it's over. I'm going home. Just another mission accomplished, right?
I'll never forget what I saw back there, right? Never.
How's your leg?
Better when this painkiller kicks in.
And the international community had just announced its official recognition of the election of the new president, Jamal Sheikh Sharif.
Jamal Sheikh Sharif, one of the most dangerous warlords in the country.
And now, sources report that he and all his government were assassinated in what appears to be an unclaimed attack.
You have to find Jamal and eliminate him.
Hopes were high that the newly recognized President Jamal Sharif would be able to put an end to the hostilities that have ravaged his country for many years. A number of world leaders have already expressed outrage at what appears to be nothing less than a cold-blooded execution.
You have to find Jamal and eliminate him.
لماذا فعلت ذلك؟ فكرت أنك صديقتي.
You lied to me.
What are you talking about?
Jamal wasn't a warlord. He was the president. He was the democratically elected president.
Your point? We're not politicians. We had our orders.
You knew I wouldn't have murdered him. So you lied to me.
Welcome to the CIA, Jodie. It's not fucking choir practice in case you haven't noticed. Now, we had a job to do, and we did it. End of story.
This might just be a fucking job to you, okay? But I don't go around killing people because some four fucking star general tells me to.
What's going on? Listen, you calm down, all right? We'll get back home and we'll talk about it, okay?
You manipulated me. You used me to do your dirty work.
What difference does it make, Jodie? He was a dead man walking with or without you.
I have blood on my hands. Some kid lost his father because of me. Because I trusted you. Because I trusted we were doing the right thing. What am I, me, Ryan? A toy? Some fucking puppet that you can just do whatever you want with?
We're getting massive turbulence.
Fuck!
I can't control it!
Did you also lie to me that night in my apartment?
Jodie, for God's sake, you're gonna kill us.
No one's ever gonna lie to me again, Ryan.
Jodie! Fuck!
They ran away.
You can't run away from them. They'll hunt you down and they'll find you. You've got to come in, Jodie. We'll talk. I'm sure...
Oh, it's over, Nathan. Through being your toy. You tell them that if they try to find me, I'll kill them.
Jodie, listen...
Tell them, Nathan. I'll kill them.